This is Andy Perloff, Boxing Social in association with Betfred. I'm delighted to be joined by British boxing legend Ricky Hatton here in Manchester. Ricky, firstly, how are you?
I'm good, all right. Can't complain. Looking forward to tomorrow night. Got two lads on the undercard as well, so it's going to be another good night.
Let's touch on your guys first, Ricky. What are you expecting to see from the pair of them come tomorrow night when he comes back?
Well, Ibrahim Nadim, he's only he's 5 unbeaten. He's got a 4-rounder. It's a lovely platform for him to perform on and impress and look the bill and look the part. He's at that learning stage where he's fighting the journeyman's different styles of opponents, and it's hopefully he'll impress. It's a good platform for him. But I mean, Brad Rea, also his last fight on Sky against Smith was a real, really good fight. Fighters fight, as they say in the trade, you know what I mean? He showed that he's ticked a lot of boxes in that fight, Brad. And he's been working really, really hard in the gym with his coach, playing Eunice, and and myself. And the main event, Khan and Brooke, what a massive, massive, massive bill to be on. I think it's going to be an absolutely great, it's going to be a really great fight. And for my two prospects to be on the same bill as that at the Manchester Arena, being local lads, yeah.
It's been an exciting night for you all then as a team. Ricky, on that main event, Khan Brook, what are your thoughts? What are you expecting to see tomorrow night?
Well, a lot of the fights that have been made lately are 50-50 fights. I'm going to sit on the fence and say it's a 50-50 fight as well. I mean, it can go a few ways. You know, Khan will bank a few rounds early with his hand speed and his movement. And as long as Kell Brook can get through them early rounds with not as much facial damage, and he can work him here and keep him working type thing, he might have a chance down the home straight. Amir Khan, if he stays disciplined, which sometimes he doesn't do, if he stays disciplined and uses his speed and his footwork, he could win it by a mile. And Kell, we all know Kell's punching power, and Amir's been down a couple of times. Kell could end it at any one time, so I think that's pretty much anything could happen. I just think if I had my last pound to put on it, I think Amir will win a few of the early rounds. Kell will make him work, but I think Amir will get drawn in like he always does, and he's more likely to get drawn in as he's a little bit older, not quite as fitter and not quite as quick. He's more likely to get drawn in, and I think once he gets drawn in, I think Kell might clip him with one. Because Kell, I've had lads that have sparred with Kell. My brother Matthew boxed Kell. Sergei Rabchenko, who was the European light middleweight champion, he said Kell's very, very heavy-handed. And knowing from that them personal experience, I think that just might give me the edge in picking Kell Brook, but only by that much. You know, if Amir goes and boxes his head off, wouldn't surprise me anyway. But if you're asking me where to put my money, I think at some point Kell will cop Amir with one, I think.
A lot of people think no matter what happens tomorrow night, it will end within the distance. Do you agree with that?
It what?
But a lot of people think no matter what happens tomorrow night, it will end within the distance. Do you think there's a stoppage bound to happen tomorrow night, no matter what?
No, it's very hard to say. I think if Amir's going to win, he's going to win it on points. He's going to have to keep a disciplined performance, jab and move and use his footwork for the whole rounds and not get drawn in. But, you know, maybe Amir can punch hard enough to knock Kell out, of course, you know, because obviously they're both getting a little bit long in the tooth. Ish, but I think if you're asking me, it'll either be Khan by points or Brook by knockout. And Amir's not saying Amir's not capable of knocking Kell out, but no, I think if I was going to, I think most people would admit that Kell by points, Amir by points or Kell by knockout. Yeah,
Ricky, just want to quickly touch on the heavyweight scene before I let you enjoy the rest of your evening. Fury White, obviously, we saw those massive purse bids a few weeks ago. Dillian been silent since, but provided that goes ahead, what are your thoughts, Tyson Fury and Dillian White?
We're just discussing it actually 5 minutes before you sat down, to be honest with you. I think, you know, Tyson's the best heavyweight in the world. Dillian is a horrendous, massive puncher. you know, and Tyson has been down a few times. And, you know, there's only so many times he can keep going down and getting up. But I think since he changed camps, he's gone to war and he's been in exciting fights, hasn't he? You know, the second fight, he destroyed Wilder. The third fight, it was an up and down, you know, barnstormer, brilliant to watch. But I think if he goes back a little bit to the old Tyson, you know, just, you know, box him, let the storm blow itself out a little bit and then put his foot on the gas down the home straight, I think he could probably stop Dillon. But I mean, if he goes in the trenches deep a little bit early, I mean, Tyson shows a great chin, he keeps getting up, but one day that day will come where you don't get up. And that's what I worry for me, mate. But I'd say Tyson. I just hope they get signed, and it'd be one of the biggest heavyweight fights since Lewis Bruno, won't it?
Also, just get your thoughts, Ricky, on Anthony Joshua. He's looked set to face Alexander Usyk once again. What advice would you give him, Ricky, when any defeats you had during your career, you'll bounce back? What would you advise Anthony Joshua heading into that?
I think it's very, very simple. I don't think he needs to change camps. You know what I mean? Usyk has masterful boxing ability. But, you know, and the way you beat masterful boxing ability is by using your size, your aggression, you know, all the attribute advantages that AJ had, he didn't use. You know, the only way Usyk was going to win was by outboxing him. So why would you try and outbox? Why would you try and outbox him? I think if he'd have put the pressure on, uses his size, his weight advantage, his height, his reach, and his boxing ability. AJ's got good boxing ability, you know what I mean? If he puts that all on him, you know, I think it was so one-sided the last time. I think people will probably say I'm crazy, but I think, no, if he turns around and throws a kitchen sink at him, you know what I mean? Calculated aggression, use your size, your strength, you know, your all your physical attributes, I think he can win it. And I think that, I think, when people say, what can you do better in the other fight? For me, it's fucking obvious. He's got to use all his, you know, all the attributes. He didn't. Tried to beat Usyk at the only chance he had was by trying to outbox him.
Final one, Ricky. How's Campbell?
He's doing all right, to be honest with you. His training camp's gone good. Another fantastic event and bill for him to box out at the O2. Another change of opponent, another learning fight for him, and so at this stage of the career, fight as often as you can, different venues, different opponents, different styles, take the knowledge in of learning from it, and hopefully in a few years time he'll be where Kellen and I'm at tomorrow.
Well, Ricky, we'll leave that there now. I'll leave you to enjoy the rest of your evening. Thank you for speaking to me in Boxing Social.
Pleasure, mate.